Okay, hey everybody, welcome to another episode of On the Wrist from Off the Cuff. Today I have something a little bit different. Obviously, we're zoomed out a little bit more because we're reviewing some products that are a little bit larger than typically what you might find on my channel. So these are some travel cases, and they're actually from the brand Daily Watch. And a little bit about them, they are one of the largest social media channels with over 2.5 million followers on Instagram alone. Now, these particular cases, you know, they're curated by genuine watch enthusiasts that are just as passionate about the watch collecting hobby as you are. And these demo units were kindly provided by Daily Watch free of charge. They did provide a discount code for you guys if you want to use the code AVERAGEBROS for 5% off of their current 10% off sale. That'll total out to about 15% off. So I think that's pretty cool. Now, in terms of these two cases, although they are meant to be travel cases, they actually do double really well for at-home storage as well, thanks to the size and scale. Here you're going to have a four row case, four slots, and then eight slots here. Of course, with this particular layout, we'll probably just go ahead and try to run and gun through one full ramble here without any cutting away, because there's a lot of ground to cover, more so the watches inside versus the cases themselves. I think the construction is really good, but we can go ahead and jump right in. Firstly, to this piece, which is pretty cool. It actually has you can actually have this customized and personalized. It's known as their personalized travel watch roll, and this is the extra large size in the black and blue colorway, black with blue on the inside. Check that out, very vibrant, absolutely pops, looks fantastic. And then you do have your basic, and then for those of you who are fans of the channel, you might recognize some of these watches which were recently reviewed. I do highly recommend you guys go through the history because there's some really good stuff here. But let's go ahead and take a look at this pillow. So you can see, very nice from that perspective, fits well. I do have a 7.5 inch wrist, and this has just a little bit of squeeze on there, and it works really nicely. Also, you can see that's not centered, so it has a clear upper and lower, but if you need to reverse that, that's always an option as well. This is the beautiful Christopher Ward C60 Trident 300. This is the latest iteration, and again, the latest model that I've actually reviewed on my channel from the brand, and I think this thing looks immaculate. But we're not here necessarily focusing on that. We're checking this out. So, as you can see, we have all button snaps here. And this thing is pretty cool. In terms of the sizing, guys, it's about 12.5 inches by 4.3, and then in terms of the height here, and then the thickness is just going to be about 2.9, so just under 3 inches. And I think it's quite tidy, nice flat bottom, and you guys can see the stitching is all very well done. And then in terms of that leather grain, definitely nice and plush, and you can see squishy to the touch, which is nice. It's just like inside your car, of course you're going to want those touch points to feel nice and plush and quite durable. So I dig that flat bottom really works in terms of laying things out so they don't slide around. And again, the nice plush blue interior is very cool. It's this velvety interior. And then of course everything can remove, everything can slide in and out, and this should fit about 95% of the watches that are out there. Of course, some that are super huge, of course, won't fit. And then for those of you who might have really, really small wrists, in terms of securing this pillow and how much squish there is in there, there's still plenty of squish to go. But if you have a really, really small, you know, maybe 6 or below inch wrist, you'd be kind of smushing. Just because this type of pillow doesn't have that M shape in terms of having compression. Speaking of that, let's check out, and again, these were all reviewed recently, from the Precedus to the Chrono Tokyo, the Blue, and then of course this beautiful Christopher Ward. Definitely check the channel history for that. But yeah, I think this is a really cool, handsome one. easy peasy for travel, and then you do have that nice, you know, personalization, which I really like. I think it was executed really well. Of course, there is a bit of a limit in terms of characters, so I could only fit, you know, the abbreviation for average bros, but I don't know. I think it's pretty neat there, and you can see the sheen in the leather. Very nice for what you're getting. And oh, did I mention the price? So $198. So $200, not the cheapest, but definitely not the most expensive. If you guys really get into leather goods, especially around watch collecting, you guys know there are straps that cost that much, right? Like a two-piece strap can cost $200, let alone a full-on leather thing. And then yes, there are cheaper options in terms of a four watch slot setup, but again, this one is really well made. You have the flat bottom, you have the nice tight stitching, the plush exterior in terms of that very nice leather grain. It's not, again, it's not the most expensive. It's definitely not the cheapest. And yeah, some of you are into super expensive ones and you're going to think that this is a complete steal at $198. But remember, you can also get an additional 5% off if you use that code. I don't get any kickback or anything for the code, but anytime a brand offers a discount code, I try to take it so that if there is anybody that was on the fence about buying something that they see on my channel, at least they'll get a deal on it. So there's that. Very cool. We'll slide that over here and bring this in. Now, what's really cool about this case, apart from the color, is look at the material here. So this one is a bit larger and also a bit more expensive, but not as more expensive as you would think, guys. $238, which for a 8-piece case that's also travel ready and has a cool design like this, which we're going to get into, I think this is actually quite a deal, especially considering when you think about it, there's much smaller cases that are going to cost within this range, if not more expensive, depending on the brand and, you know, the type of leather. But here, I love this Hexacon Green Saffiano 8-slot watch box. Sorry about that. And it's a nice mix between a watch box and a roll, as you guys can see here, flat bottom. But it does have the roll kind of layout. Check that out. Ooh, yes. This is my Seiko Alpinist collection. So for those of you that are fans of the channel, big fans of Seiko and the Alpinist, you're going to enjoy this spread right here. And check that out. Speaking of a spread, once you open this, it actually gives you a little workstation, which I think is really, really cool. Especially if you go to, let's say, some watch meets or something like that. We'll just move this up here. Yeah, you go to a watch meet, right? Like for me, I'm local to San Diego, so I'll go to those SD Chrono Group meetups. The cool thing is you bring something like this, you can lay stuff out. So somebody wants to check out the watch, boom. Or somebody has a watch roll, they can pull everything out. You can pull them off the pillows, leave them on the pillows, whatever you want. But the nice thing is you have this extra space that is definitely velvety to the touch. Now this one is going to be much larger, actually it's going to be slightly shorter lengthwise. It's going to be 11.8 versus the 12.5, but then it's going to be 7.8 inches in terms of that width there, and then the height is going to be 3.7, so a little bit taller as well. But again, you're getting something that's a bit more robust, and when I say a bit more robust, I mean this thing is, again, it's kind of classified as a watch box, but I think a lot of people, when they think of watch box, they think of, you know, wood, glass tops, all that fancy stuff. But this right here, this is what I like, is that it can absolutely be home storage, but at the same time it 100% works for travel, and if anything, it excels at travel storage. We have, of course, my original. We can actually pull this up if you guys want to kind of see them all at once, which I don't know when the last time or if any time I've ever featured all of these on screen at the same time. You can see the old school there, the JDM Alpinist, the US Special Edition Blue, the SPB Shark Tooth, also the Baby Alpinist. Then we have, of course, the Unlimited, which actually now is discontinued and skyrocketing in value, the Mountain Glacier, which is a UK regional special. And then we do have, of course, that Ginza in terms of the Laurel Alpinist style. And then this really cool one, which stands out even more now, the Rockface Alpinist, which is the only Alpinist with a brushed bezel. Check that out. Very cool. And if you're wondering what bracelet is that on there, because I have it also on my blue Alpinist, that bezel is, I'm sorry, bezel. That bracelet is actually a pre-Sarx Presage bracelet, and it fits perfect. Okay, so hit the record limit there, unfortunately. Let's pick up where we left off. That bracelet, definitely check it out. I do have, episodes dedicated to this bracelet. I think it's really fun and cool. And then you have, of course, the other baby Alpinist, and this one is gorgeous, and it's actually on a bracelet from Uncle Straps. You can see that beautiful tropic colorway with the nice, texture to it, as well as the gilted layout. I mean, that's probably one of my most worn Alpinists, just because of how different it is, and it really doesn't have to compete with much because of, again, that very unique colorway versus a lot of these. I mean, different shades of blues. I don't wear too much green already. A black dial, you know, even this one with that kind of grayish black, all of that can, it can be a lot of different things that you're going to be competing against. But this case, one of the things that's great about it, check it out, M-shaped pillow. So this cushion here is going to be what really adds a lot of value if you have a smaller wrist, because now you can take it and you can compress that down for your smaller watches. So it's a smaller bracelet or a shorter strap or whatever it is, if you want to just store it that way, the nice thing is, you know, especially if you have a leather strap, it's nice if you store it on something round, it helps break it in without stretching it out because it's a fixed position. But the nice thing is you do have that option, and you can see everything fits quite nicely, slides in and out. Again, they didn't reinvent the wheel here, but I think in terms of the offering, in terms of materials, in terms of the fit and finish, the price point, I think this is definitely worth a look. Like, these are really well done. Again, they're not the cheapest, but they're also far from the most expensive. $238, minus 5%. Again, if you use the code, under $250. I mean, I could easily see this from a more, well-known leather company that sells more luxury leather goods charging, $800 for something like this. In terms of the construction, in terms of how much material, in terms of just how well thought out. I mean, this thing is cool. And there are more expensive models that are out there that don't even offer 8 slots, that don't offer, you know, the M-shaped pillow, that don't offer snaps everywhere, and a beautiful workstation that can fold out when you do have your watches parked. So I don't know, there's something really cool about that, and you know, honestly, I just dig it. So for those of you that are fans of the channel, I appreciate you sticking out. And if you're new to the channel, definitely check me out. I definitely focus more on wristwatch reviews and EDC stuff, pocket knives, wallets, stuff like that. But as you guys can see, I also do have some other hobbies in terms of cameras and everything like that. And I will be expanding into that space for, so for those of you, any of you that were interested in kind of seeing some of that within, on the coffee table and wanting to expand more, let me know down in the comments if that's something that resonates with you. I do find that there are quite a few folks that, of course, there's crossover where there are automotive enthusiasts, watch enthusiasts, camera enthusiasts, or just, you know, people who like premium gear, premium quality things, and definitely aren't always looking for the cheapest thing. Everybody's really looking for that bang per buck proposition. And I think that's what this channel has mainly been about in terms of following my own personal journey. There's been a lot, and I think this fits within that in terms of bang per buck, right? So again, not the cheapest, not the most expensive, but absolutely lovely for what you get, not overpriced. You're not paying a lot of extra for the brand, of course, although a lot of you probably know Daily Watch just because, yeah, they're I guess the largest social platform within this space. But honestly, it's such a diverse space. There's a lot of people that, you know, they collect certain types of watches. I mean, think about this. These are all these outstanding little micro brands that are doing, I mean, Swiss, French, Japanese, American assembled. You know, you have the whole gambit. So there's so much, you know, breadth in terms of the things that you can kind of get into within this hobby. And yeah, I think some of the things that cross over, of course, is going to be good storage. You guys know I have way too many watches. So having storage options like this that look good, that also travel well, I love that because I can take this on a weekend up to the Bay Area. I'm originally from the Bay Area. Now I live in Southern California, but I can take something like this, you know, take my four watches with me that cover all different types of genres, field, dress, you know, ornate dress, and then, you know, a sporty do-it-all diver. And yeah, I can take that with me, and I think that's really cool. And then on the other side, I can have, you know, a huge collection. I shouldn't say huge, a decent collection of modern alpinists, mechanical alpinists, you know, and say, hey, look, this is kind of fun. I can store them all together. It makes me less likely to kind of feel like I need to part them out or sell them off because I can have them and display them and keep them in a way that's going to be really fun. And then who knows, maybe 10, 20, 30 years from now, you know, my kids can have a little fun with these and, you know, maybe the values could possibly go up after all that time. But one thing I did want to point out for those of you that are fans of the channel, I did this for you. Look at that. Time hack? Yeah, that's right. Time hack. Seconds hand. So I set all these. Normally, come on. I'm not going to just set all these watches and let them run. But I know that people always appreciate whenever I do that, you know, for my videos. So that's something that is, you know, it's very satisfying to see. And for those of you that, oh man, what about this? I forgot to check. Hey, here you go. Yes, absolutely. These are all also on time running there. So beautifully done in terms of the execution. I think very fairly priced. So closing thoughts, guys, let's see. Let me check my notes here. Yeah, these are well designed and I think more solid feeling than your typical, you know, Amazon type of rolls. Nothing wrong with those rolls by any means, but you know, there's nothing wrong with a Timex. There's nothing wrong with a Casio, right? But some people want more. Some people want something that's a little bit more elevated and are willing to pay the difference. So there you go. Yes, also there are more expensive options out there. You know, some of the cheapest solutions, you know, this is going to be more expensive, but not that much more expensive, which I think is pretty cool. Especially again, you consider the volume. Yes, you can get like a three row or you can get a single row and you can get those relatively cheap. But once they start going up in size, even for the cheapest ones, they start getting, you know, expensive comparatively, I think. So that's where you get the trade-off. Yeah, I think these are definitely worth the asking price. I think these designs are definitely commensurate with the build quality. So if you like the design, I think you're going to be happy with the build as well. It's not like you're going to be let down. Or if you think these designs are lame or whatever, then, you know, hey, that's your prerogative. But I don't think you're going to be let down by the build quality. And I think the designs are actually pretty smartly done. Flat bottoms, angles, you know, again, doubling as something that you can use at home or, you know, abroad. I think that's cool. And again, guys, use the code AVERAGEBROS for an extra 5% off of their current 10% off sale. 15% off. That's not too shabby. So if you decide to buy, cool. If you don't, that's fine too. But again, if you were going to pull the trigger, I would definitely prefer that you guys save money. So use the code if you can. All right, guys. Well, let me know what you all think down in the comments below. If you like the video, please like. And if you already, please subscribe for more content just like this. Thanks, guys.